Hi students, welcome back to today's class. Now we are going to see the advantage of postfix expression over infix expression. So till now we have implemented how to evaluate that is convert infix expression into postfix expression. That examples we have seen in the previous video. Now we are going to see what is the advantage of converting infix into postfix expression. Why can't we leave infix expression itself to the computer? So an infix expression is difficult for the machine or computer to know and keep track of precedence of operators. Okay, so computer will not able to understand. Okay, will not able to understand what are all the operations it need to perform. So if we are writing the expression in the form of infix, okay, so that's why we are making use of this postfix expression. Okay, so an infix expression is difficult for the machine to know and keep track of precedence of operators. On the other hand, that is the one difficulty, and another hand is a postfix expression itself determines the precedence of operators, as the placement of operators in a postfix expression depends upon its precedence only. So based on the precedence only, it is going to be placed after the operand. Okay, so therefore for the machine it is easier to carry out a postfix expression than an infix expression. So for a machine, no, it is easy to carry out the postfix expression in order to evaluate the expression. And another one, postfix expression determines itself the precedence of operators, and it's very difficult for the machine to understand and keep track of precedence of operators in an infix expression. So these are the some of the reasons why the postfix expression is this useful over the infix expression. Okay, so next we will see evaluation of postfix expression using stack. So as postfix expression is without parenthesis, because we all know that postfix expression is written without the parenthesis only. Okay, it can be evaluated as two operands and an operator at a time. So this becomes easier for the compiler and the computer to handle. So this will be easier for the compiler and the computer to handle it. Evaluation rule of a postfix expression states that, so we need to see the evaluation rule for the postfix expression. So evaluation of postfix expression is also one of the implementation of the stack. Okay, so while reading the expression from left to right, so whenever you are given with input postfix expression, it is going to be read from the left to right. Okay, push the element in the stack if it is an operand. So when you are reading the element from left to right, you need to push the element into the stack if it is an operand. Next, you need to pop the two operands from the stack if the element is a binary operator. So next, if you are reading any operator, that is binary operator mainly means you need to pop the two operands from the stack top. Okay, in case of not operator will perform its operation on single operand only. So pop one operand from the stack and then evaluate it. Okay, push back the result of the evaluation. So after finding the result of the evaluation, you need to push the result back into the stack itself. So that is going to be moved to the top only. So repeat it till the end of the expression. So repeat the same process, that is first and second step, till the end of the expression. So for binary operator, two operands are popped from the stack, and for a unary operator, only one operand is popped. Unary means one, binary means two. So then the result is calculated using the operands and the operator, and it is pushed back into the stack. So let us see the algorithm for evaluation of a postfix expression. So reading of expressions takes place from where? From left to right only. So we need to read the given expression from left to right. First one, read the next element, that is first element for the first time. Okay, so first time, that is going to be first element, otherwise it is the next element. If element is operand, then push the element onto the stack. If elements is operator, then pop two operands from the stack, pop one operand in case of unary operator. Okay, evaluate the expression formed by the two operands and the operator. Okay, so two operands and operators, if we know, then we need to evaluate the expression. That means we need to find the result, compute the given expression, then push the result of the expression in the stack end. Okay, if no more elements, then pop the results, else go to step one in order to read the next element. If there are no more elements in the given expression, so then what we need to do, you need to pop the result from the stack, because that is the final answer in the stack. Otherwise we need to go to step one. If there are some expressions or elements in the given expression, we need to go to the first step, that is read the next element, and then everything is over, then you stop the process, end. Okay, so let us see one example. Two examples are we are going to see here. One is using arithmetical expression and another one is using involving logical expressions. Logical operators will be involved in the second one. Both we will see for implementation of postfix expression, that is evaluation of postfix expression using stack. So given postfix expression is AB plus C into D slash. Okay, so this is the postfix expression. So for the variables, that is operands A, B, C, D, the answers, inputs are also given. For A, value is 2. For B, the assigned value is 3. For C, assigned value is 4. For D, assigned value is 5. Okay, so the expression, you all know that. Okay, first element is operand A. Starting from left to right, we are going to scan the element from left to right. So start from A. If the element is operand, that is A, push A into the stack. C, stack 1. Second stack. Okay, so this Roman letters at the left side indicates the stack number. So down it is written, stack numbers are written, just see it when I'm explaining the theoretical part, you just see the picture. Okay, second element is also operand B, so push B also into the stack, that is in stack 2. So now the stack pointer top is pointing to top of the stack. Okay, and then third stack, the third element plus is then operand. Okay, AB plus only, no, AB plus, then C star. So plus is an operand, pop two operands from the stack, that is A and B. Okay, and evaluate the expression. So A plus B will be what? 2 plus 3, 5. Okay, so which operand is placed down? That will be a left one, and the right one will be the top. Okay, so like that you need to pop out and you need to perform the operation. Push the result 5 into the stack. So 2 plus 3 will be giving the answer 5. So push it 5 into the stack 4. And then next to C is an operand, push down to the stack. And then X is an operator, that is multiplication is an operator, pop two operands, that is 5 into C. 5 is placed down, so that will be placed at the left side into C. So 5 star, C value is 4, 20. So 20 you need to push back into the stack 7. And then next division is an operator. So two operands, that is 20 and D you need to push now. So 20 and D is popped out. Now 20 by T. So 20 by 5 will be 4, that is pushed back. So this is the final answer. So end of the expression, popped from the stack, thus the result is 4. So this way we can evaluate the postfix expression. Next example is following expression, evaluate. You need to evaluate the following expression in postfix form using stack and show the contents of the stack after the execution of the operation. So you need to read the given expression, logical expression from left to right. So expression is true, false, true, not, false, true, or not, and or not. Sorry, and or and. So logical operators are involved. So this is logical expression. So now stack, first stack is holding the first operand, that is true. Okay, true is an operand, it is pushed. Not, or, and are the operators. Okay, so true is pushed, then false is also pushed, and then true also pushed in third stack. And in the fourth stack, when it sees the operator, not is a unary operator, so that only true will be popped out, only one operand will be popped out, so that not is applied on true. So what will be the answer of fourth? False. Okay, fourth one will be false. Okay, so that is pushed back into the stack. Then fifth one also false, that is operand, that is going to be pushed. And then sixth one also true, that is also pushed here. And then seventh one R operator. So when it says R operator, two operands are popped out. True or false will give you the answer true only. Okay, so that will be inserted here at the top. Okay, then in eighth stack, operator will be not operator. So only one will be popped out, that is true will be popped out. So if you apply not on true, false will be the answer in stack 8. Okay, and in stack 9 and operator. So false and false will give you the false answer. Here this true is missing. So in stack 9, the bottom true, it is missed here. Just add it in your book. Okay, draw and add it. True you need to be placed at the 9th stack. Okay, and then and operator, you need to pop the two operands. So false and true will be applied on and. So when both the values are true only, and will give the true answer. Otherwise it will give you the false answer only. So false and true will give false as the answer. Okay. So this is the final answer. You need to pop the final answer from the, this is the result of logical expression evaluation using stack. Next one, evaluation of prefix expression using stack. So for this, no examples are given. Just you study the rule alone. Okay. The prefix expression is also without parentheses only it will be written. So operators are placed before the operands. So the prefix expressions are evaluated by the compiler by using two stacks. Two stacks are going to be used. One stack for symbol, okay. Another stack for storing the number or operand value, okay. So for like that, the two stacks are going to be used in the prefix expression in order to evaluate the expression, prefix expression. Next, in the next class, that is in the afternoon session, I'm going to give some exercises for you related to stack applications. So infix to postfix expression conversion using stack, and then expression evaluation, that is postfix expression evaluation using stack. So related to this, you may get some questions. So be ready for the test. And the previous topics, whatever I have covered, from that also you may get some one mark related questions. So prepare that also. Last week videos also you can go through if you want. Thank you, students.